hallelujah, every year after year, every New Year's after New Year's, we're praying and we're asking God for all of these New Year resolutions. How many made some? How many made some? Come on, be honest. Some said, I'm going to get a little skinnier. Some said, I'm going to grow my hair. Some said, I'm going to cut it. Some said, I'm going to stop eating beef. Hallelujah. But a lot of us have made New Year's resolutions. But God is saying tonight there is a holy shift coming. This is not really a popular message, because when you talk about holiness, the people of God, the church of today gets a little scared. Because nobody wants to live holy. Nobody wants to live right. Nobody wants to lay down their cares and their sin. So I know I've lost about five of y'all. I know I got y'all. I expected that. But I come to talk to the other five that are interested in what God is doing. They want to know what God is doing next in their life. Not the ones who want their fancy tickle. You know, the ones who want to hear a prophetic word or a pathetic word, whatever that may be. Hallelujah. Those who want to hear something that's going to tickle your ear, but that's not going to deal with your spirit. I come to talk to those people who are tired and, hallelujah, don't want to live in a life of sin anymore. But you want to do what God has called you to do. You want to identify your purpose. It really doesn't matter if you get more clothes. You get more, this thing is ringing and it's irritating me. Hallelujah. It really doesn't matter if you get more clothes or you get more houses or you get more land. But you really want to know what your purpose is. How many say that tonight? God, I really want to know what you sent me here for, because I know that there is purpose in me. I come to talk to you tonight. Not the watered down Christians. We've seen enough of that. We know how to do that real good. But Psalms 24 says, who may climb the mountains of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy temple? Those who have what? Clean hands and a pure heart. Mother, you said it. Who do not worship idols, and those who don't lie. Uh-oh. I come to talk to those people tonight. The holy rollers. Somebody say holy rollers.
Holy rollers.
The dedicated souls. The devoted Christians. The consecrated ones. The one that's mature. And the ones that are honest. I lost my father, y'all. My God. This message is to strengthen the Elijahs of our time. Who understand that total obedience is the only way that you're going to make it. This next move of God is not going to be by people who are not living right. Despite a popular belief, the Lord is not raising up another unfaithful leader. So stop praying for God to give you more and you have not done anything with the Lord that he's given you. God says, I'm removing, I'm pulling back the covers. Because there's a holy shift coming. God is calling forth the Elijah of our time. Those who spoke and the atmosphere changed. Come on, y'all gonna help me tonight. Those who spoke and the climate changed. The Bible says that at the word of Elijah, there was no rain that fell for 3 years. Am I in the book?
Yes, you are.
I said, am I in the book? There was no rain that fell for 3 years. Those who will shift the atmosphere at the very word of God. Amen. Those who will consecrate. Those who will lay down their plate. Those who will pray all night without ceasing. God is sending Elijah on an assignment. And after this great miraculous move of God, he sends the test. Isn't that my God? I said, isn't that my God? After God uses you in a mighty way, then the test comes. After God uses you, after you say, I'm giving it all over, I'm turning back, I'm turning from this whole world of sin, then the test comes. Elijah wasn't so great that God couldn't test his very waters. Don't be fancy, because hallelujah, to heal the sick, speak to the blind and they receive their sight, speak to the deaf and their ears pop open. Don't be surprised and don't think more of yourself than you ought to. But the Bible said that Elijah, he was a prophet. It doesn't even give much information about his history. You want to know why I said God, you're so awesome in all you're doing? Because he didn't want to, it wasn't about